Today I'm gonna talk about writing paragraphs. First, what the meaning of a paragraph? A paragraph is a group of related sentences that discuss just one main idea. Can a paragraph discuss more ideas? That's to say, more than one idea? No, it can't, because each paragraph should discuss just one main idea. What about if you've got more ideas that I'd like to discuss? So, in this case, I should have more paragraphs. So, if you've got more ideas you'd like to discuss, so you should have more paragraphs. Why? Because each paragraph discusses just one main idea. A paragraph may stand alone by itself. So that's to say, I can write just one paragraph. Or a paragraph may also be one part of a longer piece of writing, such as an essay or a book, or maybe a technical report. What's the form of a paragraph? Each paragraph should start with a space. The first line of the paragraph should start with a space. Only the first line. What about the rest of the paragraph? No, we don't leave any spaces. So, each line or the beginning of the paragraph or the first line of the paragraph should start with indentation. Indentation means a space. Only the first line of the paragraph. What about the rest of the paragraph? No, we don't leave any spaces at all. Just the first line only. Okay, what are the elements of a paragraph? Each paragraph has three elements: a topic sentence, supporting sentences, and some paragraphs have a concluding sentence. If we are talking about just one main paragraph, or our topic is only one paragraph, so we must have these three elements. If we are writing an essay that has many paragraphs, so in this case, it's not a must to have a concluding paragraph or a concluding sentence, because we're gonna have a conclusion for the whole essay or a conclusion for the whole article. Let's talk about the topic sentence. This is the first element in the paragraph. A topic sentence is a complete sentence that introduces the main idea of the paragraph. So again, what's the topic sentence? The topic sentence, this is the most important sentence in a paragraph. It usually indicates what the paragraph is going to discuss. Where do you usually put the topic sentence? Usually, the topic sentence comes at the beginning of the paragraph. I said usually, not always, because sometimes we can put it at the end of the paragraph. Pay attention that the topic sentence has some important points to remember. Number one, each topic sentence is a complete sentence. What the meaning of complete sentence? Any complete sentence must have at least one subject and one verb, and it gives you a complete meaning. For example, if I say driving on freeways, so where is the verb? We don't have a verb. Somebody may tell me driving. Now, driving, it's not a verb. This is gerund, verb ing. This is noun, not a verb. Again, the following sentence. How to register for college classes. Here also, we don't have a verb. One may ask me, what about register? Pay attention that register, it's not a verb because this is infinitive. To register, this is infinitive, not a verb. And also the rise of antiphones. So here in these three sentences, we don't have verbs. So they cannot be a topic sentence, or these are not a topic sentence, because we said that each topic sentence must be a complete sentence. A complete sentence means that you have a subject, at least one subject and one verb. Also, any topic sentence contains a topic and a controlling idea. This is number two. What the meaning of topic and what the meaning of controlling idea? A topic sentence is... What the meaning of topic and controlling? Topic, this is the subject itself. What am I talking about? Controlling idea, what exactly I'm talking about in this topic? For example, if I'd like to talk about gold and I say just gold. Gold, this is the topic. What about, what exactly I'd like to talk about gold? Gold has two important characteristics. So here, two important characteristics are controlling, or the controlling idea. So, a topic sentence contains both a topic and a controlling idea. It names the topic and then limits the topic to a specific area to be discussed in the space of a single paragraph. So again, have you got now the meaning of topic and controlling? So again, topic, it means the subject itself that you'd like to talk about. What exactly are gonna discuss in this subject? It's the controlling idea. Let's see, for example, the following example. Driving on freeway requires skill and alertness. So driving on freeway, this is the topic itself. I'd like to talk about driving on freeway. What exactly I'm gonna discuss in this topic? I'd like to talk about it requires skill and alertness. Okay, what about the second sentence? If I say registering for college classes can be a frustrating experience for new students. So what's the topic that I'd like to talk about? Registering for college classes. What exactly I'd like to talk about in this topic? That it has become a frustrating experience for new students. Then the last example, the rise of indie films is due to several factors. So again, what's the topic? What's the main subject that I'd like to discuss? The rise of indie films. What exactly I'd like to talk about? Several, that it has several factors. The third element to remember about the topic sentence is that the topic sentence is neither too general nor too specific. What the meaning of too general? If the topic sentence is too general, so we cannot cover it in just one main paragraph. We need many, many paragraphs to discuss it. And if it's too specific, so we cannot find words to cover the whole paragraph. So that's why the topic sentence is neither too general nor too specific. Again, the topic sentence usually comes at the beginning of the paragraph, because we said before that the topic sentence introduces the main idea of the paragraph. So that's why it comes at the very beginning of the paragraph. Like the following examples, like the following example about synonyms. Synonyms, it means meanings of words. So here you have an example about that. And some writers may write the topic sentence at the end of the paragraph. So they may start with giving examples or giving a series of facts, and then the last sentence is gonna be the topic sentence. But which example should we follow? Is it to start with that or to put it at the end? No, it's preferable to start the topic, to start the paragraph with the topic sentence. So the best place to put it is to start the paragraph with the topic sentence. The second element in the paragraph is supporting sentences. We said before that number one, we have the topic sentence, and then the second element is supporting sentences. What the meaning of supporting? Supporting sentences, all the sentences that develop or support the topic sentence, I call them supporting sentences. So they explain or prove the topic sentence. These supporting sentences may be examples, statistics, quotations, and facts. Here you have two examples on supporting sentences. The first example in paragraph one, it's a paragraph without support. And the second one, it's paragraph with support. Look at the second example, paragraph with support. Here you will find the writer uses all kinds of supporting sentences. You will find quotations, you will find statistics, you will find examples, facts, everything. Is it a must when we come to write a paragraph? Is it a must to use all kinds of supporting? No, it's not a must. We can just use examples. And by the way, examples, this is the easiest way to use. Again, pay attention that supporting sentences usually start with, for example, for instance, such as, the last element in writing a paragraph is the concluding sentence. The concluding sentence signals the end of the paragraph and leaves the reader with the important points to remember. If I ask you a question, what's the function or the purpose of the concluding sentence? Number one, it signals the end of the paragraph. Number two, it leaves the reader with the most important ideas to remember. Another question, if I ask you, how can you make a conclusion? The conclusion can be done in two ways. What are they? Number one, summarizing the main points of the paragraph. And number two, repeating the topic sentence in different words. This is what we call restatement. So what the meaning of restatement? It means that you repeat the topic sentence, but with changing some words. So pay attention that in conclusion, I can ask you two questions. The first question I may ask you about the purpose of the conclusion or the aim of the conclusion. So in this case, you have to tell me that it signaled the end of the paragraph. This is number one. And number two, it leaves the reader with the most important ideas to remember about the paragraph. The other question that I may ask you is how to make a conclusion. The answer is that you can make it in two ways. Number one, summarizing the main important points mentioned throughout the paragraph. And number two, repeating the topic sentence but with changing some words. Or just you can say restatement of the topic sentence. When you come to make your concluding sentence, you should start with a word referring to ending the paragraph, like, for example, finally, lastly, in brief, therefore, in short. All these words must be followed by a comma. Or you can start the concluding sentence with, for example, the evidence suggests that, there can be no doubt that, these examples show that, we can see that. So you have to start the concluding sentence with a signal word or signals referring to ending the paragraph. Here you have a paragraph followed by some questions. The first question is to identify the topic sentence. What's the topic sentence here? The topic sentence is gold, a precious metal, is prized for two important characteristics. Okay, what's the topic and the controlling idea? The topic, this is gold. What's the controlling idea? Controlling, I mean, what exactly I'm talking about in this sentence or in this paragraph. So here I'm talking about two important characteristics in gold. Okay, the rest of the sentences that follow the topic sentence, they are supporting sentences. The last sentence in the paragraph, this is the concluding sentence. Look here, it starts in conclusion. This is what we said. We said before that each concluding sentence should start with a signal word referring to ending. So here it's like in conclusion.